हेलो सर, हेलो,
यू स्टार्ट।
एम आई
ऑडिबल, यू कैन स्टार्ट।
आई कैन नॉट स्टार्ट द स्क्रीन शेयरिंग सर। इट इज सेइंग दैट यू कैन नॉट स्टार्ट स्क्रीन शेयर व्हाइल अदर पार्टिसिपेंट इज शेयरिंग लाइक दिस एंड आई एम ट्राइंग।
स्क्रीन देखा जाच्छे?
हां सर, देखा जाच्छे सर।
देखा जाच्छे सुप्रजीत?
हां सर, यस सर। गुड आफ्टरनून सर, आई डॉक्टर सुब्रज्योति विश्वास, सेकेंड ईयर पीजीटी एमडी जनरल मेडिसिन, बर्धमान मेडिकल कॉलेज। टुडे माय टॉपिक इज जनरलाइज्ड कोरियोबेलिज्म इन ए केस ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रियल साइटोपैथी व्हिच रिस्पोंडेड टू द माइटोकॉन्ड्रियल कॉकटेल। इंट्रोडक्शन। माइटोकॉन्ड्रियल इनहेरिटेड डिसऑर्डर्स आर फेनोटाइपिकली एंड जेनोटाइपिकली हेटेरोजेनस ग्रुप ऑफ डिजीजेस इन्वॉल्विंग मल्टीपल सिस्टम्स। माइटोकॉन्ड्रियल इनहेरिटेड डिजीजेस मैनिफेस्ट थ्रू द डिसफंक्शन ऑफ द पोस्ट माइटोटिक टिश्यूज, कॉजिंग द वेरियस न्यूरोलॉजिकल एबनॉर्मलिटीज, कार्डियोमायोपैथीज, एरिथमियास, एंडोक्राइनोपैथीज, रेनल ट्यूबुलोपैथी, हेपाटोपैथी एटसेट्रा। हियर वी रिपोर्ट अ केस विद द माइटोकॉन्ड्रियल इनहेरिटेड डिसऑर्डर्स प्रेजेंटेड विद द वेरियस न्यूरोलॉजिकल एबनॉर्मलिटीज सच एज द कोरियोबेलिज्म, कॉग्निटिव इंपेयरमेंट, सीजर्स, sensory neural hearing loss along with the hypoparathyroidism. Our patient, a 14-year-old Indian male with a history of the sensory neural hearing loss, bilateral ptosis, focal tonic-clonic seizures of the upper and the lower limbs on either side, the postictal transient muscle weakness since the childhood. He was admitted because of the generalized seizures 3 to 4 times a week since last 1 month. Actually, the neurologic exam revealed cognitive impairment, ptosis, hypoacusis, features of sensory neural hearing loss, proximal quadriparesis, and absent internal reflexes. Chobostek sign and the Trousius sign were positive, and there were carpopedal spasms. Convulsions was associated with the prodromic symptoms of the tingling and numbness sensations surrounding his lips. Clinical neurologic exam revealed mildly decreased attention span and other mild cognitive impairment. Minimental score examination was 22/30. Ptosis did not worsen with the fatigue or the upward gauge. Lead twitch and hopping sign was negative. Clinical course, the blood investigation revealed the hypocalcemia, hyperphosphatemia, elevated creatine kinase level, and hypoparathyroidism. Prolonged QT interval. During hospitalization, the patient was developed chorioballism and treated symptomatically with the haloperidol and tetrabenazine. NCCP brain revealed hyperintensities in the basal ganglia, which is probably the basal ganglia calcification. Cerebral MRI shows the bilateral non-enhancing altered intensity in the T1 and the T2 with signal blooming in the GRE. Nerve conduction studies showed mildly reduced compound muscle action potential. Needle EMG revealed short duration low amplitude polyphagic motor action potential suggestive of the myopathy. Other vasculitic, neoplastic, and the metabolic causes ruled out. Combination of the recurrent focal and the generalized seizures with the torus paresis, bilateral ptosis, bilateral sensory neural hearing loss, moderate cognitive decline, and choriobalism, primary hypoparathyroidism, massive endocrinopathy, related other clinical complexes, and along with the proximal myopathy and cranial neuropathy suggested a probable of probability of mitochondrial inherited disorders. Search for the mitochondrial etiology was initiated with the revealed heteroplasmic missense mutations in the mitochondrial DNA. There was a mitochondrial DNA missense mutation which was in the 13513 position, where guanine was replaced by the adenosine. Treatment with the mitochondrial cocktail results in the significant improvement. Discussion. The most interesting phenotypic feature of the presented case is the severe primary hypoparathyroidism, which explains most of the neurologic manifestations. Hypoparathyroidism is an extremely rare manifestation of the mitochondrial inherited disorders, which is commonly associated with the attributed literature, which is associated with the Kearns-Sayre syndrome, mitochondrial encephalomyopathy with lactic acidosis and stroke-like syndrome, and mitochondrial trifunctional protein deficiency syndrome. Seizures can be either due to the hypoparathyroidism induced hypocalcemia or due to the mitochondrial inherited disorder itself, but in our case, the seizures are probably due to the severe hypocalcemia. Cognitive decline, ptosis, and the myoneuropathy were the classic neurological manifestation of the underlying mitochondrial genetic perturbation, for which we study the mitochondrial genetic studies. Conclusion: so diagnosis of the mitochondrial inherited disorders in patients with hyperkinetic movement disorder in the form of chorioballism, severe hypoparathyroidism, epilepsy, cognitive impairment, and hearing loss is a potential possibility in a bedside clinics. Thank you, sir.